David Bahnsen is with us, the Bahnsen Group CIO. Look, this is not one of the major economic indicators, but it's an interesting idea of how we feel about things. And apparently we're feeling pretty good.
Yeah, my thesis has been for some time that the key, though, the consumer felt good throughout most of the Obama years. The key is business investment. That's what was really pushing the economy bigger throughout 2018. Business investment sentiment has churned in the last couple months, I believe, because of the trade war. So it's the consumer sentiment is there. We can take it for granted to some degree. Americans love to spend. Business investment is what we need. CapEx, that's what we're watching.
Okay, the Dow Industrial is not reacting very much to those numbers. We were up 60, now we're up 54. I'd call that virtually no reaction. David Bahnsen still with us. I don't know whether you think that socialism is going to break up in Europe or whether the EU breaks up. I don't know. But we're going to get some serious developments in Europe this coming week. Could it wash over to us and hurt Wall Street?
So in a short-term sense, you have to be able to look at this differently than a sort of long-term generational perspective. Most of Tammy's comments are cultural and sociopolitical and completely correct. But one of the things that neither of you talked about is the role of their currency. A single currency doesn't work with a bunch of different countries that have their own economies, different strengths and competitive advantages. That's been the fundamental flaw. The European Union is not going to break up in the next, it's not imminent.
That's understood.
But what I believe you're talking about is a volatility spillover. It's entirely possible, but I want to play the other side. Global capital has to go somewhere. We've seen this now for 9 years. Other continental weaknesses have been U.S. strength as dollars flow into the U.S., into our debt markets, into our equity markets. So I do believe there's a sense in which the weaknesses they're suffering there can be a benefit to U.S. markets. Longer term, you just have to watch the Italian bond spreads. That's really the barometer for what's happening. It's telling you the fear. It was Greece 8 years ago. We could follow that and see what was going on.
So you would agree that an economic mess is developing, has developed in Europe.
For 20 years.
The immediate consequences to America could be some money coming in, but longer term, we take a hit.
But here's the thing, it's very important for our viewers to understand, nobody can make money trying to predict exactly when they're done kicking the can down the road. They have done an amazing job kicking the can down the road, but at some point that ends. It's a failed experiment, the European Union. Ultimately, we can expect there to be more volatility, but I agree that long-term, the European Union is a failure. Short-term, I think that we should look to the benefits that are in the U.S. markets.
Got it.